established. Yo.
So you finally got to meet him. You've seen his armor. You've seen his sword. Yo. You've seen his descendants.
I heard about you. I heard you're pretty cool. Is it true? That's the thing that was grabbing me.
Go.
We're going.
You're getting no advice on this one. I love him.
One hand looks cool.
Well, his left arm is wrecked. And also, it's an important detail. Artorias' sword in all of its interactions, right, is actually wielded in the left hand.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. You're right.
Which means he's...
I just remembered that.
He's fighting you with his off hand. This is his bad hand.
Okay, AoE.
Ooh!
That's so fucking bad.
Oh.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That's correct.
He's the coolest.
That's
ever.
Correct. God damn.
He's the coolest.
Okay.
I love this guy. He's the best. Ew. I forgot about that. Oh wow, he's doing his big thing really early.
Okay.
Oh, that's a delicious muffin.
Okay.
Okay. Running into that was no good.
So,
you have a decent roll, yes?
Yeah, I can see. I can see.
No. Why are you so cool, Artorias? Is it your strong blue design?
It looked like a dodge cancel.
Oh, there you go.
I'll run into this next this time.
Yep.
It's a pretty small one.
It's not that big. The main problem is the buff that he gets from it.
Ooh.
The buff that he gets from it allows him to do that. That's a power within killed you.
Yeah, okay. Okay. I'm gonna try a little bit more D. See if blocking is.
He needs the D, folks.
Is I think.
Would you say that you need more D in your life?
Cool.
Is that the plan? Oh. Love you, Artorias. Hey, which do you think is cooler, Artorias' armor or?
Hold on a second. He's growling at me. And he's leaving a trail of... I can block a little bit.
He's leaving a trail of what I would describe as goo.
Yeah.
Fucking love that shit. You can see some of his movesets being incorporated into later weapons. Oh, so good.
Ah, why am I drinking there like an idiot? Occasionally, he's gonna do two.
Mm-hmm.
Did you get the feeling that he's like the first inkling towards Bloodborne?
No, but... Whoa! Okay.
Huh. Splashed a little bit of goo at
you. Up at me. Yeah, you got a goo.
Gooing up the place. Jesus.
Alright, here's your buffed Artorias. Even gooier.
And stronger.
Much.
This is basically a DT. Oh, man. I love it. Oh, that's the best.
That looks really cool.
I can block after that one. Yes. Okay.
Yes!
That's the exchange. And we end neutral.
So it's been a long time since I fought him. But I remember one of the tricks being on those enormous jumps that he does. You can, in some cases, walk under him. Like by walking straight forward.
Interesting.
And he'll go behind you. But you might want to throw a roll on it just to be safe. Right like that. Oh shit!
Should probably keep some humanity out.
I can feel the instant that you drink, he's gonna fly into the air.
Can't read those. I can read these.
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh, perfect!
Alright, more.
You're absolutely killing it on low S.
Except for the triple.
Yeah, he does the double and the triple.
Well, okay, that's his power geyser.
Yep.
All right.
Hey, bitch. Oh, poor Artorias.
So cool. And you can't, in fact, get that sword.
Nothing to do with
it. No, I guess not. If he wants to do it, he'll just do it. Oh, well. Oh, guts. I like you with the blue. Wow.
What a massive difference in health drainage on Poke compared to the recent bosses and enemies that you've been fighting.
Yep.
The DLC pretty much assumes you're going in at fully kitted out weapons and what have you. Oh, so cool. You mad, bro? He mad. Oh. I can't even tell if that actually has a body explosion on it.
It did. It hit me.
Oh, yeah, you're right. You're super right. Yeah.
Walk out of that.
Yep. As long as you start a little early. I think with the exception of the giant overhead and the flipping kicks and the dash move, you can walk out of a lot of it. Oh, that wasn't so bad. Trying to see if he has any tell between multiple
flips.
I'm
looking for it.
And it doesn't appear to be.
I'm looking for it.
It appears to be if he wants to do it, he'll just do it.
Shit.
You're doing like twice as much damage to him now. Oh, on counter hits. That's the trick.
Take a second to confirm.
Mm-hmm.
Best I can do.
Was there part of you that thought he was going to do a fourth?
No, but it could have happened, right?
It could have, I guess, maybe. I think three is his maximum. Imagine this is something similar to what the Four Kings were like before they became gigantic, weird...
That was a weird one.
...like monster dudes. Hey, luckily you have the poise to just stand there and take that. I never really thought about it until now, but at... certain distances, his aura makes it very difficult to see what he's actually doing.
Come on!
Thank you. Well, hopefully you beat him. Like I said, kindling. So yeah, that humanity is not lost as long as you manage to pick those souls up at some point during the fight. Oh, it's a massive damage boost. That's what it is. Okay. You know, I was just thinking about it. I don't know if I've ever mentioned it, but because it just occurred to me. Maybe it occurred to me in the past. I don't fucking know anymore. But how I love the soul design of picking up your souls, like the corpse run aesthetic, kind of locks you into boss encounters. Whereas you're in a situation where you lose resources at the boss, and in order to potentially not squander those resources, You're stuck fighting that boss until you win. Alright. Do your little purpley thing. Which you look very good during. That's the spirit. Fortunately, your wait to hit confirm thing means that he can also wait to hit confirm you.
So it seems.
Well, that doesn't hit on the right side.
Ah.
Got him.
Hey! How you doing?
All right. He kicked my ass. You saw there was a nice pause there where, like, I was staying neutral on him.
Yeah.
Because I was like, I need that pop. I need to pop the heal on humanity. I don't want to waste this shot. Because, yeah, he's a two-fuck-up-and-you're-done guy.